Well, jobs could be lost in the motor industry after changes to regulations, which it's claimed are causing chaos. A new scheme has come into force, tightening the rules for modifying vehicles.
Car enthusiasts who turn wrecks into street machines and hot rods will be hit, as well as purpose-built vehicles like prison vans and conversions that give disabled people their mobility. What was legal last week now requires a full vehicle test, including crash tests.
If it's got doors on it, you need to do side intrusion tests, you need to do seatbelt tests, and that would in effect destroy the car. So you'd really need to build two in order to build one, and clearly that's not practical.
This 1966 Mustang has had a $200,000 rebuild, but can't be registered until it's done a 160-kilometre-an-hour brake test.
To do that test first, I think is ludicrous, because at the end of the day, I don't believe it proves anything.
Wally Bancroft converts vehicles allowing disabled people to drive, but has been struck off the list of engineering certifiers because he isn't a mechanic.
It looks as though it could be the end of me. Yeah, as in this business.
Families who need to get their vehicles modified, whether to put on a disabled ramp or other modifications, now have to go through a process which is more costly and more complicated.
Industry experts say millions of dollars in rebuild work is on hold. Car builders say the changes to engineering rules are already costing jobs, and they want the state government to sort out the problem. But Roads Minister Duncan Gay insists the new scheme will stamp out fraud and make vehicle modifications safer. John Hill, 10 News.